New at 11 tonight, a mysterious case of animal abuse in the upstate.
A woman says for the second time in 2 months, her two labs were shot with pellet guns while she was at work. News 4's Liz Loheis joins us live and local in Greenville tonight with more on this story. Liz.
The owner of the two dogs lets them run freely in and out of the house into a fenced-in backyard. But after the abuse they've gone through, she will only let them do it under her watch.
I came home one Sunday morning and noticed he had some blood on the top of his head.
The first time it happened, the owner of Labradors Porter and Spice thought it was a fluke.
We wondered if maybe somebody had shot a pellet gun in the air and that it had, as a, you know, fluke, come down on him.
But when the owner, who doesn't want to be identified, realized her dogs had been shot a second time, she knew it was intentional.
I can't sort of bring myself to imagine them just being in the backyard, kind of minding their own business and having somebody shoot at them.
The vet who examined Porter and Spice after the latest incident found a pellet lodged inside each dog.
If they had been shot from a different angle or directly through the chest or something, it could have been fatal.
The owner describes the neighborhood on Curitan Street in Greenville as close-knit and safe. She never imagined she'd have to worry about the safety of her pets. The owner has filed a police report but says until she knows the person responsible is caught, she won't let her dogs roam freely in and out of the house.
If kind of caught now and identified, maybe something in the future could be prevented.
Porter and Spice are expected to make a full recovery, but their owner can't shake the worry and fear for her much-loved pets.
I think these are the sweetest dogs I've ever encountered, and I know I'm biased, but honestly, the thought that somebody could look at them and pull the trigger just is one of the most disturbing things I've ever encountered.
Anyone with information on the shootings is asked to call Crime Stoppers at 23 Crime. Liz Loheis, WYFF News 4, live in Greenville.